it's Ivan, and my project this weekend will be to print polycarbonate on my printer Creality CR10. Why polycarbonate? Well, it's kind of a challenge for me because I read on the internet it's extremely difficult to print and only some thousands of dollars price tag printers can handle it. Second, it's because parts printed from polycarbonate are extremely strong and heat resistant. So what it seems I'll be needing to successfully print polycarbonate is a heated bed that goes above 135 degrees Celsius. Well, this heated bed will never go above 100 degrees Celsius. So I'm relying here on the build surface I showed you in a previous video that is actually a sheet of polycarbonate. So I assume polycarbonate on polycarbonate should stick very well. Second, I read it's a material that shrinks even more than ABS if the temperature, the surrounding temperature is not stable. So I have enclosure, it's okay. And third, you need a nozzle temperature above 290 degrees. Well, with my current setup, it's no issue for me. So let's print polycarbonate on Creality CR10 printer.
I bought a spool of polycarbonate from a local supplier that claims it's a pure polycarbonate. It came very well packaged in vacuum sealed packaging. I heated the nozzle at 260 degrees in order to clear the old ABS filament in the nozzle by manually extruding from the new PC filament. My first print was a fan holder for E3D V6. It went very well. The part sticked great on the polycarbonate sheet. It is printing at very slow speed of 30 millimeters per second, temperature of 290 degrees for the nozzle and 85 degrees for the build plate. When the build plate cooled down, I removed the part very easily. My next print was a diffuser for my homemade video light. The previous one was from PLA and as you see, it deformed completely from the heat of the LED when I forgot the light on all the night. It was again relatively easy to take the part out of the building plate. By the way, if you are interested in cheap video light, There is a link in the description below to this powerful LED. It's 7000 lumens and it requires about 2 amps of power supply at 12 volts. I printed next some holders for the polycarbonate build surface. The polycarbonate is much more flexible than a regular glass, so in order to attach it well on the aluminium heat bed, you need either more paper clips or to print parts like those ones. Polycarbonate should be great for this purpose. If you print these holders from PLA, they will soften because of the heat of the build plate. If you print them from ABS, they will be flexible. Here you see my next print. I printed a dice with 100% infill. It printed great and it was as well easy to detach. Then I printed some T-nuts. Those came extremely strong. I am using a lot of these and normally I print them from ABS, but those from polycarbonate are even stronger and very rigid. So far I didn't have a single issue printing with polycarbonate. Those small parts printed very well. Now, however, I'll be trying a more complex part. I redesigned this part from my dual Z-axis setup and I count on the polycarbonate to make it stronger and more rigid than the existing ABS part. Here you see my design. So I let the part print over the night and what I discovered in the morning was this. The part, as you see, is bended. It was warped from the one side, from the build plate. And it's due to the material shrinking when cooling down, very similar to the ABS. So what I decided is to use the heater in my enclosure and to heat the surrounding air temperature to 50 degrees like I do for ABS and see if it will help with the shrinking. Here are my settings. The print is already at 40%. So you see the enclosure temperature, 51 degrees Celsius. Printing temperature 290 and the bed is at 85. As you see, the temperature of the hot end is oscillating a lot. I have a heater of 40 watts and at this temperature it is not able to maintain it steady. So it's oscillating something like 5 degrees. The other issue I discovered is my hot end was leaking. It is leaking polycarbonate between the heat break and the nozzle, I think. And I can only imagine what extrusion pressure is needed to continue printing in these conditions. So here's the time to promote the extruder I'm using. It's a Bontech BMG dual drive extruder clone from Triangle Lab. It is maybe my best investment. For the last 3 months, it's printing absolutely maintenance free and it delivers. I mean, it will supply the material no matter what. So if you are looking for a new extruder, check the affiliate links in the description for how to buy it. There is also a link for the stepper motor I'm using. It's a pancake one, 23 mm thick, very light and very performant. As you see, it is working in the extreme conditions of heated enclosure. The part printed fine and again it was relatively easy to take it out once the build plate was cooled down.
So the part printed very well. It's extremely strong and it is just what I needed for my printer. So in conclusion, printing polycarbonate on Creality CR10 is possible with good extruder, E3DV6 hot end. I think this hot end reaches the limit with this filament. Don't forget to use Capricorn Bowden tube inside, even if it is direct setup. You still have few centimeters of Bowden tube inside the hot end. Regarding the build surface, okay, you don't need very high temperatures as some websites advise. What you need is a sheet of polycarbonate and then I print it with a bed temperature of around 85 degrees. It sticks very well. And finally, for big parts, you need heated enclosure in order to avoid the shrinking and warping. So if you like my video, please hit subscribe. I publish normally a few videos per month in the area of 3D printing, either for printer upgrades or for some 3D printing projects. Thanks for watching.